we've embarked on a remarkable era of regenerative neuroscience.
Cell replacement strategies were often not considered to be part of even the repertoire of what we could consider for things like neural disease, neurotrauma, and these things are now a reality with the use of stem cells.
Technologies of induced pluripotent stem cells, of direct reprogramming, just open up a remarkable set of opportunities. The era is here. We are in clinical trials, and that's very cool. While there are challenges with the animal models, there have been huge advances that have occurred, which facilitate the potential translation from molecule to man. Examples include the use of a transgenic mouse models. These have enabled remarkable advances to occur. And there have also been advances in clinical trial design to also enable more efficient examination of potential therapies.
I work on neural stem cells. So neural stem cells are found in a very well-defined specific region of the brain, both during development and all the way up into adulthood. So we have this capacity in our brain to have cells that can make new neurons, new oligodendrocytes, new astrocytes, and these are found in a region that we can actually manipulate. Turns out that even under baseline conditions, these stem cells in the brain and in the spinal cord have the capacity to self-renew and make new cells that go on to integrate into normal neural tissue. So it's my cell, I take it from my skin, it's non-invasive, I give it specific factors, and it turns back to a cell that then can then go on and make all the different cell types of my own body. Then I can use these factors in a dish, make those cells turn into the neurons I need, or the stem cells of the brain that I need, or a cardiac myocyte, take those cells, they're now mine, they came from my skin, I use these genetic modifications and now I can put them back and repair my own body with my own cells. So that's really the promise of induced pluripotent stem cells. These cells that have been recently probably the biggest step forward in stem cell biology in years.
So all of this going forward, I think, bodes very well for the future. And I think that Ontario is extremely well positioned in this regard. In that we have strengths in the area of medicine and surgery. We having a publicly funded healthcare system has advantages in terms of enabling clinical trials. There are amazing opportunities related to the funds that have now been made available. And there is a remarkable expertise in Ontario related to regenerative medicine, stem cells, bioengineering, and so on. So all of this, I think, bodes very well for the future.